这是曼哈顿的一些街道正在上演的典型场景，搬家卡车和决定离开纽约市的人的纸箱。而搬家公司跟许多其他生意不同的是，他们不得不拒绝客户。
So many people are moving to Florida, California, and Texas. Those are the three long-distance destinations that we're seeing. And local or relatively local, they're moving to New Jersey, Connecticut, Long Island, out of the city into the suburbs. Feels like forever.
纽约市目前关门的企业更多，干净的地铁车厢几乎是空的。而枪支暴力事件正在增加，许多人在搬去邻近的州，像新泽西州，那儿的房价正在上涨。
One of the things everyone mentions these days, they need office space in their home. That is an unaffordable luxury in New York City apartments. So people are looking to have an extra room, an attic or a basement that can be converted into an office and used for remote work. A lot of people are asking for that.
A daycare closed in mid-March. We started working at the same dining table, and I work with kids remotely on Zoom. I need complete silence because I sing with them, I tell them tales, but instead my husband would be right next to me on endless calls.
带着一个婴儿在纽约市的一个小公寓里度过四个月的封锁期后，他们决定搬到新泽西州一个宽敞的住房。他们可以拥有一个游泳池和两间办公室。他们说他们喜爱这个城市，但担心大流行病不会很快结束。
The thought that we could spend another year in a lockdown felt like insanity. So I'd rather find ways to get to New York City every day to get to work than risk spending another year locked in a small apartment without a balcony.
他们的许多朋友都在仿效他们的做法。过去十年，纽约市的空置公寓数量已经达到历史新高。尽管市政当局试图说服人们留下或搬回来，但到目前为止，很少有人听从。美国之音记者纳尔逊，纽约报道。